for.
The situation is slightly different, but the physics, I would say, is the same. In this case, there are no solutions here, but there are the so-called conical solutions. But the conical solutions are not solutions of the free action. They need a source. So if you have just pure gravity, then and this is m, from m equals 0 to infinity, there are solutions, and then here there are no solutions, and then at m equals minus 1, or depending on the various conventions, but at the negative value of m, then you have ADS space. So in this case, this is ADS space, and then from m equals 0 to infinity, there are black holes. And again, you have exactly the same discussion. There's a critical temperature where the minimum of this curve is at the same value for the ground state, but then for the smaller values, the black holes will dominate, and for bigger values, the ABS ground state will dominate. So this is again a Huygens bridge transition in 2+1 dimensions. Okay, so what we shall do here is to do something, as I just said, it's a very old result, but in the case of higher spin black holes. So that means I will work in 2+1 dimensions, which is a theory where you can couple higher spin charges in a very easy way. And then consider the same problem. I will have a partition function given by a set of n minus 1 charges, Q2, Q3, Qn, with their corresponding chemical potentials. Mu2 and Q2, you can think of them as like the first one would be the temperature and the mass, and then all the other ones are the highest spin charges. So Mu3 to Mun are fixed numbers, the chemical potentials, and the entropy will be some function of only the charges. So the idea is to look for the minima of this free energy, and then try to track the different phases. Yes. You will need to. Well, I'm not very sure. Sorry, my hearing is not very good.
So the question is, when you consider these n charges, do you assume that they form a closed algebra S with respect to Poisson brackets, or just any conserved charges are okay in this construction? Higher spin.
I mean, by this construction, the charges will form a closed algebra.
Yeah, that is the question.
Yes.
Okay, thanks.
They will do. Okay, so my table of contents will be a quick look at the SL and R Chern-Simons theory and how these extra charges arise. then looking at some comments about the spectrum solutions for these theories, and then looking at the phases, and then we will see is that, so first we'll have to find the solutions, it says interesting set of solutions, then we will look at the partition function for this problem, and then look at the different phases for given values of the chemical potentials. And then we will see first that there are Hawking-Page transitions, so there are values of the chemical potential where the solution or the system would prefer to be on the ground state and not on the black hole solutions. So that would be a situation where the Hawking-Page will act with the Hawking-Page transitions. But also, it's a rich set of transitions because there could be transition between black holes. So that means that I have some given values of the chemical potentials, and then I have a black hole, and I move these chemical potentials smoothly, very slowly, and then if I cross a given boundary, I cross it, then this black hole will go into another black hole with completely different properties. So that's what we'll call a transition between black holes. This is something you don't see in Schwarzschild ideas, for example. So this is very similar. I mean, the mathematics is exactly the same as the Van der Waals-like fluid. Of course, the formulas are very different, but the pictures at the end are exactly the same. So it's like going from the gas phase into liquid phase. It's a very similar situation. And also, there's a second-order transition where you will see this critical line connecting different black holes, and then you move in the other direction, and eventually this critical line disappears, and this is a critical point. So this is basically what I will be talking about. As you see, this is very old stuff in a way. This conference, recent developments in ADS3 50, but this is actually a very old application of statistical mechanics. So this is my only slide on Chersimons, SLM Chersimons, and the gravitational interpretation. So the idea is that you start with two SLNR Chersimons fields. You need two of them, I will call them A and B. In the literature you will see the one is called A and the other one is A bar, and then when you have complex fields there's a bar and alpha bar, and then it becomes very complicated in notation, so I prefer A and B, it's a bit simpler. So I have two Chersimons fields, A and B, they live on the SLNR algebra, and the equation of motion for both of them are the same, just the Chersimons equation, and the trick is that if you define a field that I will call E at the difference of both, and then W at the sum, of course this is an invertible transformation, and then from out of E I can build this trace of EE, trace of EEE, in full E, etc. up to NE. If I have chosen already my N, so this will stop at N. If you compute, the next one will give you 0. So that means that in particular if you have N equal 2, then the only one you can define is this one. But if you have bigger N, then you can define all these objects, they're all symmetric. And the beautiful statement is that if A and B satisfy these two equations, then all of these will satisfy Fromsdahl higher speed field equations well in advance. This is two Pascal dimensions on ADS background. So this has been, well, it's a development, there's a lot of, I was not very careful on citing that I should have included here the literature, there's a lot of literature in this problem. So from my point of view, what I will do is that this gives me a theory of interesting fields interacting. This is interesting. This is an interacting. And the equation of motions are extremely simple. This is just two Chersimons field equations. So this theory, first of all, has an asymptotic WN conformal algebra, and there's some reference back here. This was done simultaneously by two groups. This is to analyze the asymptotic algebra that you discovered, the WN algebra. Their solutions carry all charges, so their charges associated to this algebra, and then you can build explicit solutions carrying these charges. It's not quite clear what black holes should look like, so that means that it's not very clear to define the global structure of black holes. Of course, you can find something like what looks like a Schwarzschild black hole, but it's very tricky. It's a very tricky. A black hole is not really something that looks like a torch. The global definition of black hole is a far more complicated object. And in the case of these high spin charges, I mean high spin theories, the main problem really is the symmetries involved. Now you don't have only the coefficient, but you have a much bigger group. And you want to define the horizon, for example, in a way which is invariant, and not only under the coefficient, but under a much higher, much bigger group. And that's something, to my understanding, maybe something somebody had mentioned something before, but this is not well understood. Funnily enough, even if you don't understand very well the global properties of black hole, you can compute the entropy, for example, at least for something that you can say, well, this would be my black hole, at least there's a partition function I can compute that is an entropy and a temperature well defined. Okay, so let me consider two classes of solutions. This is the simplest you can do. First of all, the problem is understanding a gauge field with zero curvature. So this is the problem. This is a diffeomorphism invariant theory. It has a zero Hamiltonian. The time evolution is trivial. The time evolution should not give you important information. Once you have decided the initial conditions, and the initial condition, of course, must satisfy the constraints, then the time evolution is just a choice of gauge. So in principle, AT, I don't have to worry that much about it unless I do something silly. But if I am carefully, if I carefully choose a good AT, then time evolution should not be part of the problem. Second, the radial component will be a gauge choice. Actually, these two things, of course, are related, but a good gauge choice, for example, would be AR equal to zero. It's just a gauge condition, and it's a good one. And A5 is really what carries all the physics. So you have, I'm working here in a manifold, let's say at the beginning it could be just R3 minus a tube. And the main point is that A5 will carry the important information. So the two possible tools makes it much more complicated. It's one of my future projects, but I don't really know how to deal with it in a clever way yet. So the main the solution that we will consider, one is ABS phase, which is this is the initial condition, this is the spatial topology. So T equals 0, this is the spatial topology, and I will say that this is just R2 and nothing else. So if this is R2, then A5, this will be my angular coordinate, is constrained by this condition. So this must have a trivial holonomy. So that leaves only one state, which is the ground state. On the other hand, the other interesting topology is R2 minus a hole, so this is an annulus, and in that case A5 is not constrained, so because there's a holonomy that I can draw.